Good.
Commissioner Belcher.
Yeah, last month we talked about the Zion Shelter, asked Holland to come back at, we asked Holland to come back at the budget session next year, and in the meantime, there was an article published in the Washington Daily News that said that the Zion Shelter likely could close soon due to lack of funds. I went back and did some research on the Zion Shelter. They are a 501c3. They did file their 990EZ tax form last year. Their financials show that last year they, in the 2014 calendar year, they had receipts of $42,000 plus or minus, and expenditures of $54,000 plus or minus, about a $12,500 deficit over expenditures over receipts. Brian has been doing some checking, and Brian, correct me if I'm wrong, but at the end of last fiscal year, they seem to have had a fund balance of around $29,000. That appears to have gone down to between $10,000 and $11,000 now. Is that about right?
Best we can estimate by doing some extrapolation.
So they are in pretty dire straits. My motion tonight is to do a one-time appropriation to the Zion Shelter of $12,500, and hopefully this will carry them through the winter and the coldest months of the year. And then next year, when budget time comes, they can approach the county manager about being included in our budget. The city of Washington does fund them the Zion Shelter at the amount of $7,650 a year right now. It has been as high as $10,000, but during the recession, the city made some cuts to not just to the Zion Shelter, but across the board. So I put that in a form of motion, $12,500.
What was that motion for, money-wise?
$12,500. Yeah, which was about exactly how much they were in the red last year.
I'll second.
I have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion?
I got just a question.
Oh, yeah. Go ahead.
Well, I'm going to support this motion, and I want to tell you the reason why. At least about the first stage, getting ready to approach winter months. And whether you believe it or not, you're going to finance and fund it anyway. To close the shelter, you're going to pay that $65 a day or longer at the county jail. So it's better to do it here where people are manageable. They're not tearing up the town. They just fell on the bad luck. And this is a wise thing to do. But the winter months coming very, very fast. And I'm going to support this motion.
I'd just like to say something on this. I'm going to support this motion myself, but I do want the shelter to come during our budget session and make a proposal so we can put this in our budget. And if we want to continue supporting, which apparently I think we do, but just make sure that your people come during budget session and make your proposal. Okay. Anybody?
Yeah, I have some questions.
Go ahead.
Does anybody know how many people average stay at the shelter year-round? Or
12 to 15 a night, probably.
12 to 15?
They are due to fire codes. And Harlan, correct me if I'm wrong.
That's the guy.
I think they're limited in the number of people they can have. And if it's okay, Mr. Chairman, we will let this gentleman come up to the podium. Harlan, you want to go up with him? Holland is on the board and the treasurer, and I think you're the night manager. Is that correct?
Jonathan Gaskins.
And but I think they're limited in the research I've done as to how many they can have at any one time.
12 a night.
12.
Do you have 12 every night?
Not right now, because the city housing authority helped us out. They had 10 spaces and they used all of them. So that's a blessing. But on average, we're full.
How many people that stay at that shelter regularly were citizens of Beaufort County.
All of them.
For years and years and years. They're all natives.
I can only account for 2 years.
Can only account for 2 years because at one time, the majority of the people that stayed there were transients. It was a hotel for people passing through.
The majority of the people that basically stand there were people coming out of the prison system. And yes, they have been from all counties. But since I've been here, it's the majority of Beaufort County and Pitt.
And where?
Pitt. We get a lot of people from the Vidant Medical Facility.
From the Vidant Medical Facility?
Yes.
Why? What were they? You mean they were released
coming
from?
Coming out of behavioral health.
Coming out of behavioral health.
Mm-hmm.
But they lived in Beaufort County. They were just taking treatment in
right.
a pit.
Okay. Is this a mental health issue that we're dealing with here that should be dealt with differently rather than us just continuing to put money into it?
Alcoholism is considered to be a behavioral mental health problem.
Right.
Along with drug addiction, and that's what we're dealing with. Majority of the people that we have either have alcohol problems or drugs.
Well, you know, I'm sympathetic to people who have been caught up in that, but these are also voluntary conditions that people volunteer for when they get in them, and those that have come out of it tell me you can volunteer to come out of it a little bit more difficultly than you got into it. So
correct.
It's a voluntary condition. I just have a problem with taking taxpayers' money, as hard as it is for these people to come up and pay their taxes, especially now that the economy has been squeezed and squeezed and squeezed, and using taxpayers' money to feed people who are going to continue to be what they are, using the money they have to buy drugs and liquor while we feed them. That's not a good system.
Tearing up the town.
Well, that's what we have the jail for.
And that's what costs the $60 a day to keep.
Well, I'm not one of these socialists that believes in solving these problems with money, so I'm going to have a problem voting for this.
We know you would.
It seems to me as though people who are in this condition are charity cases, no question about that.
Not necessarily,
that.
Because I've had a police officer's son from a well family. I've had all types.
Well,
so it's not just the down and out.
Yeah, well, you're telling me things that make me harder and harder for me to support this. But if this is a charity thing and a Christian thing, as Christians, we should be looking after the poor and the oppressed. My opinion is this is a situation that the churches in Beaufort County should be taking up the money for the shortfall for, instead of me using the police powers of the state to go take money away from the citizens to give it to somebody that I just decide needs it when they're having to work and feed their children. This is not a good thing. It is charity. It should be a Christian giving and not a police power taking, and that's what tax money is. It is a police power taking, and I can't vote for it.
I understand what you're saying, but at the same time, when you look at the flip side of it, where you say police, whatever, these people are there. They're going to be there regardless.
Exactly.
So someone has to step forward and look after them.
Can I say this? We're constantly always talking about we are a Christian nation. I mean, and I hate to preach, but the scripture says, by this all men shall know that you are my disciples. That means by this love. And Jesus himself said, when you do it unto the least of them, you have done it unto me.
Call it
so
important.
Come on and let's open up the bowels of compassion and have some compassion for our fellow man.
The compassion should come from you Christians that claim you're Christians by digging into your pocket and donating this money instead of taking a gun and taking it away from honest working taxpayers.
Mr. Chairman.
Can I say one thing?
Hold.
Okay.
Go ahead, Mr.
Mr. Richardson made one statement that I just can't agree with. And I've done it for 30 years. Alcoholism, drug addiction, is a sickness.
Yes, it is.
We don't frown at folks with cancer. So why do we frown at folks? Because they're alcoholics. A sickness is a sickness. Cancer will kill you. Alcoholism and drugs will kill you. And let me tell you, you're wrong. It's not something that people just do because they want to do it. Thank you.
Okay. Mr. Chair.
Okay, Ms. Buzzia.
Yeah, I have one quick question. I'm going to support this motion, but I have one quick question. What do we do with the female homeless? Do we send...
That's a problem.
I know. Do we send them out of the county?
Pick community shelter. That's the only place that...
Okay, that was my question.
Okay.
Thank
Mr. Waters.
Thank you, sir.
I raised a question when it showed up on the agenda, and I asked our manager to try to get some financial information. And I've had a chance to take a look at it. I think, and you correct me if I'm wrong, the money now comes from the United Way, the city, and church donations.
Yes.
People in the community.
Mm-hmm.
The thing that really concerned me is when you looked at the age breakdown that you had provided for the city, 13 to 17 years old, there was 8 in the last year.
No. I don't know where that came from.
How?
13 to 17?
This was under the budget form 3 that was submitted to the city of Washington. This is where the age group was broken down.
We don't take anybody under 18.
Okay. Well, maybe it's just in the wrong line. How about 18 to 29, 45? Is that?
That's about right.
Okay. Okay. You know, I guess I don't want these people to be out on the street. But at the same time, I agree with Commissioner Richardson. I mean, I think the responsibility still lies within the community. And the motion was a one-time appropriation with the idea of you coming back during the budget process for next year. And we adopted the policy back in, I think it was April of last year, of what we require of nonprofits.
Mm-hmm.
And you've met those. One of them was the tax filing that you've done, and the other one was the financial information. My concern going into it was, you know, was it a money management problem, or was it just turn in the way the funding was? And I mean, I've been convinced by reviewing it. I've spent as much time on this $15,000 or $12,000 request as I did on the EMS stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't think we can sit here and be anything else other than good stewards of the community. I mean, we're members of the community just like you are. And so I'm going to support this one-time appropriation.
Thank you, Commissioner Waters. All right, I have a motion and a second. All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? 6-1. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.